Hello and welcome to the OT Quick Start Guide. Today we're going to take a look at how we set up the operational technology or OT scanner, how we install it, how we start scanning, and then how we connect it to cloud and actually see our data in the cloud itself. So, OT has been vastly and rapidly expanding throughout the industry. Many industries like manufacturing, healthcare, but also public infrastructure use OT devices and PLCs, sensors, etc. to manage their environments and automate them. And now Lansweeper is able to scan those with the new OT scanner that we've released. So let's head into our test environment and show you how exactly you set up everything and get started. First thing that you'll need to do is head over to your Lansweeper cloud site. And if you haven't created one yet, then obviously you'll have to create one first. Once you've created your site, you can head over to the configuration where under installations, you can find the installers, both the regular Lansweeper or the IT installer and the new OT installer. So we're gonna go ahead and download that. And once that's finished, we're going to run that on our test server here. So before we start the installation process, I want to give you a quick overview of what the OT installer is comprised of. So we have the actual OT hub, which is kind of the central point, data collection point, where the database is also included in. And then we have the actual components that will do the OT scanning, so that we call the sensors. And similar to a regular Lansweeper installation with the, you know, the Lansweeper website and database, and then the scanning servers, we can have a OT hub and as many sensors as we want that connect to that single hub and push the data towards that hub. So with that in mind, you have to make sure that obviously the sensors, the machines that are installed, that you install those sensors on, do have access to, you know, the OT environment and can connect to those devices using, you know, whatever ports and protocols that your OT devices use. So let's head back towards the test environment and continue the installation. We're going to click next and agree to the license agreement. Then we have to choose where we want to install it. I'm just going to leave it on default. And then we get the first option with this, which is, do we want to install the actual OT hub or not? As I just explained, you'll need one hub and then you can connect as many sensors as you want to that specific OT hub. Since we don't have anything yet, we're going to leave that all on default. So you can also configure some additional settings here regarding the actual ports that are used for data transfer, as well as where you want to host the local site, what port. But I'm going to leave that as defaults. And then next, it asks you, do you want to install a sensor as well on the same device, which you can. And we're going to leave that on as well. And then it's just next, and it will continue the installation and install both the hub and the sensor on this same device. So now that the installation has finished, it will ask us if you want to open the hub UI, which we do. And then we're instantly greeted by the on-prem interface where we can use the built-in admin login to actually get into the interface. So now we have our interface here with all the options, so we can see how many sensors we have, how many protocols are configured, which those are obviously the default 7 protocols that we provide. We don't provide you with any default scanning targets simply because these OT environments can be quite sensitive to just random probes that are poking around. So we make sure that we don't want to disrupt anyone's OT environment. So we leave that blank. So that's for you to set up. And obviously, because we have no scanning targets, there are no OT assets as of right now. So let's take a look at all of the options that are available here. We're going to start with the sensors. Now, we only have one sensor, but you can, as I mentioned, install as many sensors on as many servers as you want, as long as they have access to your actual OT environment and can retrieve data from there. You know, you're all fine and you should be able to install it on there. Next up, we have scanning targets where, as I mentioned, they're empty, but we're going to quickly add one in here. We're just going to give this the name of the actual IP address. You can also add an IP range here, but we're simply going to add a single IP address. You'll have to add a schedule. So I'm just going to do a daily schedule. And you'll have to select which protocols you want it to use for scanning. You can select multiple ones if maybe you're not sure which one exactly you need to use. You could even select all of them. So we're going to hit save there. And then we're even gonna hit the scan now button that will actually trigger the scan. And while that's scanning, we'll continue on to the other tabs here where we have all of the schedules that we can use. And you can obviously create new schedules if you want a, or if you have specific preferences for a schedule. And lastly here is where we have our protocols. As I mentioned already, we have 7 protocols that we provide by default, but you're able to create and add your own protocols as well if your devices use, you know, a different protocol that isn't listed here. Now let's head over to the assets and take a look at the device. As you can see, it has already been scanned, so we can also take a look at it and look at the details here. And as you can see here, we have all of the details on the name, the manufacturer, model, serial number, firmware, and additional details here as well. And since this is a rack, we also get the rack config in here as well. Now, as it mentions here at the bottom, there is a limit. So if you do not link your hub installation to an actual cloud site, there will be a limit of the number of devices that you're able to scan and that you're able to actually see in your local interface. So it's best that you do actually link your OT hub to the cloud site. And that being mentioned, the cloud site and linking to the cloud site isn't limited to just one hub. You can install or link as many hubs as you have to your cloud site. Before we actually do the linking, I want to quickly mention that we do have additional settings here in kind of the additional menu in the top right, where we have proxy settings, maintenance settings. You can see the version info. So if you do need proxy or something like that, then you can configure it there. Now, let's actually link our site to a cloud site, which is quite easy, especially if you've already logged into your cloud site to grab the installer. All you need to do is just click the button. We'll have to do some basic prerequisite checks just to make sure that we're able to connect and actually send data to the cloud instance and the cloud site. That's done. Then we get a device confirmation. I quickly see that is correct. So we will confirm that. That's all done. We can head back, hit next. And now we can give a name to our specific OT hub so that when we look in the cloud site, we can actually more easily identify which installation is which. So this will be OT hub, and we'll call it server 2016 because that's the server version that I'm running on. I'm going to leave the description blank, and then here I have to select a specific cloud site. I have a couple of cloud sites, so I'm just going to select the OT test one here and hit create installation. And that will actually link our OT hub to the cloud site and we'll start syncing the process. As you can see here, it will give you some information on the actual site that it's syncing to, as well as when I head over to assets now, the warning is gone. So we have an unlimited amount of OT devices that we can now also see on the local interface. So now that we've connected everything, we can head over to the cloud instance or the cloud site and head over to our OT test, where it should still be empty. It is still empty, and it'll just take a few minutes for it to actually sync the data from our OT hub to our actual cloud site. So now after the refresh, you can see that we have one asset. I'm gonna click on the widget here. That'll bring me to my one OT asset that I can take a look at. And similar to as you saw on the actual local interface, if we go to the cloud interface here, we get the same data, just formatted a bit differently, but it's all still there. And similar to that, if we want to head over to the rack information, we can take a look at all the rack slots here as well, along with the name, the firmware version, serial number, and additional data there as well. Now, we've linked the hub to the specific cloud site, and by going to the configuration and installations, we can actually double check and confirm here that yes, we do have our OT hubs from the server 2016 OS linked to this specific site, and we can even see that it synced 5 seconds ago, did the last full sync. So with that, we've completed our initial installation. We've installed the local OT scanner. We've done an initial scan, We've connected it to the cloud site, and as I mentioned, you can install as many hubs and connect to those as many sensors as you want or need, so you can get all of your OT devices scanned and get an inventory of all of your OT devices in the cloud site. Now with that, this feature is still in active development, so we are continuously adding more functionality, making things better. So stay tuned for that, and thank you for watching.